Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Umunna Favor and I'll be bringing you videos that will inspire, motivate and energize you to achieve your purpose in life. So if you want to be motivated, please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click the notification bell so you don't miss any of my new videos. I have this question that have been bothering me and honestly I can't keep calm about it anymore, and I want to ask you that question, and that question is, why are you hiding? Can you please tell me? Because sometimes I sit and I wonder, why is it that people are hiding? You can cook, you can dance, you're a lawyer, you're a doctor, you're an engineer, you're a professional fashion designer, you are this or that, yet you don't want us to know. Why? What is your reason? I'm not saying, please don't get me wrong, I'm not saying you should be posting every of your activities on social media or wherever. What I'm saying is, why are you not going to companies to submit your CV? Why are you not sharing that great idea of yours with a friend? You never can tell, because Bill Gates co-founded Microsoft Corporation with his friend Paul Allen. Then why are you not advertising your business or your services on social media? Is it a personal decision? Is it out of inferiority complex? Or like you are waiting for a particular time you feel that will be the right time? What is your reason? I really want to know. Then why do you think companies spend a whole lot of money to advertise their products and services on television, radio, social networks, and whatever means that is possible? Or you think they don't know what they're doing? Now let me tell you, they are projecting themselves. So why do you think it is wrong for you to project yourself or your business or your projects? No entrepreneur gets to limelight without self-projection. It is either it is done directly or indirectly. For me, it has been a journey of self-actualization and breaking of fallow grounds in the entrepreneurial world. And I'll be sharing some of my personal experiences with you as regards to self-projection. So stay tuned. Back to business. I will not fail to tell you that there are lots of benefits self-projection has to offer. It all depends on the area where you need it most. Sometimes people say to me, Favor, this is your dream thing and you are taking it too far. And my response to them have always been, no one lights a lamp and hide it in a clay jar or hide it under the bed. Instead, they put it on a stand so that those who come in can see the light. This is Luke 8:16. And sometimes I just laugh and leave them with no response because they are not seeing what I'm seeing. There is no limit to what you can achieve with self-projection except the height to decide not to attain. Some of the personal experiences I said I'm going to share with you as regards to self-projection is, first of all, I have to do a brief introduction of myself so that you can relate to some of the things I'm going to say. My name is Umunna Favor, like I mentioned earlier, and I'm from the eastern part of Nigeria, though I live in Russia currently. And I have my Bachelor of Arts in English and Literary Studies. And during my National Youth Service in River State, this was in 2015, I learned how to knit cardigans. And while I was still learning, I started going to schools to seek for contracts to produce their school cardigans. And one thing you should have at the back of your mind in the journey of self-projection is, not everyone will accept you. So I got my nose even before I had my first years, and it was from a female headmistress, and she said, okay, let's start with 60 cardigans. How long will it take to be ready? And my heart skips because I was still learning, though I had to comport myself because that was what I was looking for. Then I told her it would be ready in 1 month. So we calculated the cost and she gave me half of the money to start the project, and when I supply, she will finish up the payment. And I left her presence. I didn't know how to feel. I didn't know if I should be happy or excited or worried. Oh my God. You know, I was learning, though I had my machine. So I got home, took my time, reassured myself, and I began to work day in, day out. I won't say it was easy for me because I made my mistakes and I corrected myself. And I had to subject myself to sit from morning till night knitting because I wasn't as fast as I am now, as at then. So it wasn't really easy for me, but within 1 month, I delivered the 60 cardigans and she loved them and she ordered for more. Honestly, that was the beginning of my success story in the knitting world, because that contract built my confidence and my knitting skills to the point that I don't really need to measure you to knit a cardigan for you anymore. If I can see you or your picture, then you will get exactly what you're looking for from me. That was how I started training people, got more schools to produce their cardigans, started a knitting institute, had students, bought more machines, and so on and so forth. Maybe I should start a channel where I teach people how to knit cardigans. What do you think? And anything knitable, not only cardigans. But that is when I get 1 million subscribers from this channel. So subscribe to my channel to motivate me. Now, getting to the bigger story. Remember, I'm still telling you some of my personal experiences as regards to self-projection, like some of the things I've benefited from self-projection. In 2015, there was a home gathering of Imo State Congress of America, and the president, as at then, Attorney Charles. Shout out to Attorney Charles, I'm still grateful till today. So the president invited me to deliver a speech on the need for skill acquisition among the youths, which I did, and I impressed everyone in attendance that day. And there and then, they concluded that they will invite me to their annual congress in US the following year. This was in 2015, so they were going to invite me in 2016 to US. So as the event was approaching, I received their invitation and a topic to deliver in 2 days of the program. But guess what? The visa was denied. I never lost hope and never relented in my business of self-actualization and self-projection. I still went about hosting skill acquisition campaign, motivational seminars for the youths. And in March 2017, I made a post on Facebook titled, "There's a seed of greatness in you beyond certificates. Discover it and let it shine." And in that post, I displayed some of my works. And out of so many comments I received, I got an acknowledgement from a US-based Nigerian. Shout out to Pastor Frank. I'm still grateful till today. So he wrote me and he was like, "With what I see you are doing, you will do better in US." And we had some conversations and he requested for my documents. And within some months, I received my master's admission letter from a US university and some documents I needed for my interview. But will I say fortunately or unfortunately? Guess what? The visa was also denied. Currently, I'm in another country, not US, Russia precisely, and I can say that self-projection is the match that lit up that candle. The world have a population of 7.8 billion people as at March 2020, and is a busy environment. No one knows what you have until you advertise it. Despite the self-centeredness in individuals, there are still people in search of destinies to give a push. That is why you see some philanthropic individuals and foundations, scholarships, but you must meet their demands before you can access those opportunities. What am I saying? The world operates a buying and selling system. You use what you have to get what you don't have, or rather what you need. You have skills, intelligence, and beauty, and you need money, fame, and network. Self-projection is the connecting point between what you have and what you need. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Wandaya said, "If you believe it will work out, you will see opportunities. If you believe it won't work, you will see obstacles. It all depends on what you believe. No time is too late to start. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a step. Day after day, 1,000 days becomes 999 days, 998 days, 997 days, and so on and so forth. So no time is too late to start. If you have started projecting yourself, kudos to you. And if you haven't, what are you waiting for? The time is ticking. You have to start now so that we can dine at the top together, because that's where we belong. Be inspired, be motivated, be energized. If you really appreciate this video, please give me a thumbs up. And if there's any part of this message that inspired you, please leave a comment for me in the comment section below, because I would really love to know. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any of my new videos. See you next time. I love you.